Hey guys! We've done basically a whole lot of nothing today. We got up today and decided that it was just gonna be a lazy weirdo day because we just didn't really have much going on. So, for homeschool today, what we did was we learned a little bit about roller coasters because we have a super fun day planned tomorrow. Where are we going?
Lagoon!
Yes. It's in Salt Lake City, if you guys don't know where that is. It's in Salt Lake City. It's an amusement park with lots of roller coasters. It's going to be tons of fun. So today, we spent a little time researching how and why roller coasters do what they do. So I thought maybe it would be good for Jordan to give you guys a little bit of a rundown about what he learned about how roller coasters work. So today's kind of going to be a one take. It's going to be maybe a couple of takes because we're going to have Jordan explain it and I want to make sure that it makes sense. But we're just going to kind of do a quick video just to kind of say, hey, this is what we're doing. And then tomorrow we're going to have a super awesome video. While Nano's getting ready, we're going to show you his mosh face. Ready, go. Do it.
Okay. Mosh face. Mosh face.
That's a good one. That's a good mosh face. What about you? Do you have one too? That's a good mush face.
Baby.
Baby, do it.
Okay. Mush face.
Mush face. Okay, you ready, Nano? Alright, let's go. Hi, Nano.
Hi.
Nano's gonna show us what he learned about roller coasters today.
Pretend someone's going on.
Be helping him explain why roller coasters do what they do. So I'm gonna start out by drawing a very basic, here's where we start, here's the train station if you will, and then we're gonna leave the train station and go up the hill on our roller coaster, and then we're gonna go down the hill, and then we're gonna have a couple of more little, and then we're gonna stop right here on the landing pad. Okay, that's gonna be our very basic little roller coaster ride that we're gonna go on. So at the very beginning, when we get into the roller coaster, Nana, what do we do first normally?
You normally hop in and put your lap bar on.
Put your lap bar on, that's right. Then when you get your lap, we'll tell you why you put your lap bar on in a minute. But when you put your lap bar on and then you start going on the roller coaster, you start going up, what's happening to the energy? How is the roller coaster gonna work? It needs energy, right?
By a chain.
The chain is gonna pull you up this big hill. You ever notice that the first hill on a roller coaster is always the highest? It's unless there's some other way to get to the top, it's always the highest, the first hill that you go down. So the chain is gonna pull you to the top of the hill. What's it creating as it pulls you up, Jordan?
Potential energy.
Right, it's creating a bunch of potential energy because you're gonna be way up in the air in your little roller coaster cart. So when you get to the top and you're sitting in here saying, yay, this is gonna be so much fun, right? There's your hands in the air. You need to get out of the way, mister. We're busy. When you go over the top and you start to go back down, what's happening to the energy, Jordan?
It's turning into kinetic energy.
Right, we're converting the energy to kinetic energy so that when we start going back down this hill, all of our energy is going straight into the ground, right? So our stomach's flying up in the air, and maybe our hat flies off or something. Some of that is because of the wind pressure, wind resistance that we're experiencing, but some of it is because our energy is going straight down into the ground. The only thing that's stopping us from plunging into the ground, which would be terrible if you're on a roller coaster, is the track. So when your roller coaster car gets to the bottom, the track grabs it and makes all of our energy, woof, go this way. The reason you have a lap bar on is to keep your body, the energy inside your body, moving in the same direction as the car that you're sitting in. So then when you get to the bottom and you feel that as you go back up, that's because that car that you're strapped into is changing the direction of the energy that you're using as you fall down the hill. And then it puts all that energy into going right back up this hill. And when you get to the top of the hill, what do you feel like?
Feel like you're so freaking heavy.
Nope, that's when you're at the bottom. When you switch directions, you get real heavy at the bottom because you gotta change all that energy that's going down is now switching directions and going back up, right? So you get really heavy at the bottom. Ugh. And then when you get to the top and it goes back this way, what happens to all your energy? It's all going this way, right?
Uh-huh.
And the only thing that's making you do this corner or do this change in energy is because your roller coaster is actually attached to the track that's changing the direction of your energy. So then you feel like you're gonna fly out of your seat because all your energy's going this way. Ah, I'm gonna fly this way. But because your car is connected to the track, it converts the energy to going back down, and that's why you feel like you're gonna fly out of your chair until you get to the bottom again, and then it switches your energy to going back up, and you feel heavy again. I'm heavy. And then you go to the top, and you're light, and then it all levels out just before you get to the end, and that's when you feel hurt. And what's that? What force are you feeling? Aside from choking to death, what force are you feeling when you feel that hurt at the end?
You're feeling all that energy.
The brakes of the roller coaster are doing what?
Sucking up all the energy.
They're absorbing all of the leftover energy that we had from this big drop at the very beginning. So it sucks it all up and it stops you, and then your ride is over.
Yeah, if it has enough energy and they don't stop it in time, you might be able to go twice.
You'd have to go back up this hill, though, because you'd never have enough energy to get all the way back up to the top. You remember that roller coaster that we made on the computer?
Okay, we are on the Science of Disney Imagineering website, and we have spent a bunch of time building a roller coaster. We're going to see now if it actually works. It worked, yeah.
We did it! You have to have enough energy to get all the way to the top, or you just roll back down. You would go back this way.
The chain was probably.
So nope, you couldn't do it twice without that chain. But you could do it all day long with the chain, because it converts enough potential energy into kinetic energy to get you around and around and around and around and around. Right?
Yeah.
Are you excited for tomorrow?
Oh, yeah!
Yeah! Mia, are you excited for tomorrow?
Yep. And look what I drew. Look, Malia, Jordan, mine!
We're excited about our trip to Lagoon tomorrow and go on some real roller coasters. Disneyland was so much fun, but they don't have too many roller coasters, so this will be a whole different kind of exciting for these guys. And I hope that we did a good job explaining why roller coasters make you feel the way they make you feel. If we did, tell us in the comments below that now you understand, finally. And if not, just say, And if you like this video,
make sure to thumbs up.
If you want to make this channel strong,
share with your friends.
And now,
good night, YouTube. See you tomorrow.
At the roller coasters. Woo!